ないで
scoops for 200 milligrams of caffeine. 150. That just take one scoop, one heaping scoop.
Okay, one heaping.
I don't know.
I'm gonna keep it real. I know I don't look like it because I have all my teeth and I'm still beautiful, but I was on the meth for 9 years. And so if that stuff gets me going, I'm gonna let the world know about the sidewalk cracker. Okay?
Because I was a sidewalk cracker.
Yeah! Oh my god. Get it in ya.
Ooh, I smell it over here.
I'm smoking it straight to the top. Are you savage? Straight savage? Oh! You know what I mean? Like, whereas you blokes, you get the flu or a splinter. Right? You act all tough. You're not tough. Let me see you push a baby out. Anyway. Yeah?
Okay,
she dropped that.
Mr. Hyde.
I'm not a feminist. I'm not. Right? That's another label. I'm just all about like gender equality. So it's like for men and women. That's what's up. Bring the women in. Make you He taught me the watermelon choke today. But we need a tape measure. Because she's a...
Rob!
Okay, come on. What do you mean? You're so much bigger.
Like, where's your tip? See, she's got another like 2 inches on me though. So.
But still, I mean, come on. There's no comparison.
I don't know.
I'm pretty sure there is.
Facebook Live to all Courtney Thunder Thighs fans out there. Fuck y'all.
I think it should be father fucking because why does the mother always have to get fucked? You know what I mean? So, but
I have a theory on that. I'm gonna leave that shit alone.
But I know what it's like. We get our tattoos and you know. So, I'd love to do the theory.
Sidewalk
crack.
She's straight to the dome.
Straight to the dome.
Straight
She was blowing powder clouds outside.
Certainly, yeah, I want to see that because
I know
she's super strong. Obviously, she's super strong. I see from squat. I took a scoop too, so I'm fucked up. I seen her squat. I looked at her Instagram and I seen her squat 405 pounds. And it's a whole lot of men can't do that shit. So I know she's strong.
That's right.
I know she's strong. But it's not a question of just sheer power and strength.
Mm.
It's also endurance.
Oh, yeah.
So that will be tested today.
It's about to be tested.
Allie Ludwig will be tested today in the Valley of the Beast. All right, we're here with the superstar, Allie Ludwig.
What's up?
In the Valley of the Beast. And if I didn't see it myself, and I seen it, and I still don't fucking believe it, this young lady's thighs is fucking ridiculous. And she is here today to take the test. You know I like to test, and the last person we had here to successfully complete the test was Follow the Leader.
Okay.
And she is also known for thick thighs.
Okay.
And she passed. She did it for 5 minutes straight. So today, we're gonna see if Allie, I say Allie because that's my motherfucking name. But it's Allie. Allie Ludwig is gonna be, and see if she can pass the test. She is a, tell me a little bit about yourself. Let me rambling on. Tell me a little bit about yourself.
Olympic weightlifter. I've been lifting for 2 years, full time. Nationally competitive, that's about it.
When you say Olympic, tell these PNA motherfuckers that don't know what that means.
All right, so Olympic weightlifting, there's two movements. It's a snatch from ground to overhead in one motion, and then the clean and jerk, which is ground to shoulder, one motion, and then the jerk, which is shoulder to overhead. So basically just lift as fucking much as you can and try to win.
That's the same philosophy that powerlifters use, and
Different from powerlifting, though.
Yeah, it is much different than powerlifting. Because with Olympic lifting, you also have to be a little agile.
Very, it's all technique, very agile, quick speed.
Yes. Yeah. And with powerlifting, you ain't got to be none of that.
No.
You can be slow as fuck. Yeah. Oh, I'm sorry, baby. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to cuss in front of you. I'm slow as. that was the thing that I won 6 world titles in a long time ago before anybody here was born. So powerlifting is much different. She has to have speed, agility, and a lot of power. It's power too. Explosiveness. She's got to be explosive.
So explosive.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So what have you done so far, and what are your goals?
So far I have competed in, I think, 6 national meets. The last one was universities, and I took gold in the under 25 championships, swept gold in the snatch, clean and jerk, and total, and I took silver in the universities, so I swept silver in the snatch, clean and jerk, total. Short-term goals, I'm trying to qualify for Pan Ams, which would be my first international meet.
Wow.
And that'll be, I believe, in July next year. And then long term, I mean, the fucking Olympics.
Of course. Pan Ams are the next thing right under the Olympics. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Pan Ams and then Worlds. Worlds is the big one. But I mean.
But not as big as the Olympics, are they?
No.
Olympic lifter, they may be.
Yeah.
People
exactly.
that are in the sport.
But the Olympics is like.
Yes, that's everybody. Yes, everybody, not into sports or whatever, they watch the Olympics, while they're on. So that's the thing that make you a world-renowned personality.
Yeah, exactly.
But for weightlifters, then the world championships is it. And then we know, weightlifting world will know.
Yes. And actually, the world championships are going to be here next year, so that's going to be sick in Anaheim.
Right in Anaheim. I got to take my ass over there and see what you're going to do. Command you to do some shit.
That's fucking right.
They ain't giving you no goddamn choice. You got to do this shit. All right. So the goals, the eventual goal,
mm-hmm.
is, of course, the Olympics.
Mm-hmm. What's the focus every day?
World championships. And what would it mean to you to be a world champion?
To be a world champion, wow. Oh man, that would, it would just, that would be the most overwhelming feeling ever, to just know that all the sacrifices I've made, my coaches have made, my family and everything that I've worked towards, I don't think there'd be any feeling close to being world champion. Anything.
Well, I mean, I can tell you from experience, you're right.
Yeah, really.
And it takes, one of the biggest steps to that is being able to tell everybody. Mm. Because once you tell everybody, my goal is to be the best in the world, then you're setting yourself up, you know, they're going to expect great things from you because you told them now that this is my goal, this is what I want to do.
And that's something that I need to get better at, for sure. I just started realizing that. I've kind of kept my goals, you know, under wraps,
right,
just because I don't want to put myself out there, but I know that when I put myself out there, I can hold myself accountable, you know, and not to prove to other people, but just for myself.
Prove it to my motherfucking self.
Mm-hmm, that's right.
But once you put it out there, then you've taken a big step because, like I said, you leave yourself vulnerable to criticism and people, shit talkers, all, I thought, how are you going to be a world champion?
And it
takes a lot of courage, and I admire that you have taken that step because it's necessary. I think it's
completely
a necessary step in order to be a world champion.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, I'm coming out there to be the best on the planet.
Mm-hmm.
And I ain't scared to tell your punk ass.
That's fucking sick. Yeah.
That I'm going to be the best on the planet.
Mm-hmm.
And I have a question for you. Mm-hmm. Which one of you motherfuckers is coming in second? Because Allie going to win this shit. I love that shit, boy.
That's fucking
sick.
That's
buddy.
So
yeah, buddy. Yeah, buddy. You got to have all it's a confidence thing.
Mm-hmm. Completely.
And the first person you have that must have confidence in you is you. You have
damn
to believe
self.
In goddamn right. You have to believe you can do it.
Mm-hmm.
I tell you what, if anybody looked the part, if there's a such thing as looking the part, she definitely looks the part. She already looked like a world champion to me.
Thank you.
So I think she's gonna do fucking very well. And you heard it here first, I predict that Allie Ludwig will be a fucking world champion. Why, CT? Because I fucking said so. That's why. All right, Al, you want anything else you want to tell me? All right, look for her, goddammit. Stay tuned and look at her Instagram. What's your Instagram?
What is my? It's Alann Ludwig. Alann Ludwig.
All right, look for goddamn Instagram.
I got
keep
a question
up with
for her, CT.
Huh?
Did you say how old you are and how much your matches
she
are?
She said she's competed in under 25. And I was,
I'm 24 years old.
24. I think that's the same age as my oldest granddaughter.
Aww.
It's 24, so she's young and she's out to conquer the fucking world.
That's right.
So hold on, world, she's coming.
Fucking antsy. That shit just made me like, let's fucking go.
Sidewalk cracker.
Oh, yeah.
Sidewalk.
Female sidewalk cracker.
Sidewalk cracker.
Yeah.
A sidewalk cracker. That's the shit.
Showing them thighs now. Take it.
Yeah, but
what's your max on squat again?
So my max is 405, 185 kilos. Snatch is 99 kilos. So that's what, like 220 almost pounds, and clean and jerk is
220.
Yeah, it's 125, I think, so like 275 pounds. Yeah.
That's some heavy shit.
Love squats. Love squats.
That is. Some
everybody squat.
Right there. Hey Kim, I didn't see you coming.
How are you?
All right, IFBB Pro Kim right there.
What's up?
She's been in quite a few of my videos. As we're celebrating strong women. Around
that's
this
right.
month, fuck.
Mm.
Have you seen my videos? You've seen Kim in them from my Magnificent Obsession movies out now. Kim starring in that, and she's an IFBB pro, strong as fuck. I worked out with her, so I know she's strong.
I bet.
So,
we did the marathon,
uh-huh.
and which is 200 reps for 225 pounds before it's done. That's the workout. That's the on the bench press. What? 200 reps for 225 pounds. That is the bench marathon. And this young lady right here, I said, she did with me, I think me and Big Rob, man. We're like, are we going to change the weight? And he said, I don't know. You ain't got to change the weight. I was like, my boy. So she's very strong, very strong.
I believe it.
You know, I coming from, you know, I have five daughters, two sons. And for me, I'm a mama's boy. My mom was the strongest woman, you know, in history. You know, and that was my hero, was my mom. So I love strong women. I love seeing strong women. That shit don't intimidate me a bit. I fucking love
That's
it.
Right. That's right.
That's what's up.
All right, Allie. All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
This shit, and I still don't believe it.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
I don't even have any words.
Hi,
sweetheart.
Hi.
Nice to meet you,
hey,
too.
Shut me the fuck up. I was like, wow. I was stunned.
Awesome.
All right, Courtney. Hot, huh? Courtney, which nickname do you want me to call you by? Thunder or Crusher? Or...
Thunder's pretty awesome.
Okay.
That's,
all right.
Yeah.
Last name. Wait. Oh, yeah, I know what it is. Wilson?
Like the twins.
Yes.
Olsen.
Right. Like Olsen, not Wilson. Olsen. Yeah. I got this fucking pre-workout is kicking my ass, man. I'm stuttering like a motherfucker. All right.
I can't wait to try it.
Court, you haven't tried it?
Not yet.
Drew, pour some of that shit in.
I'm trying to sleep tonight.
Oh, you won't shit. Sleep.
I know.
Yeah, you will not sleep.
Yeah.
She, Ali's going to be up tonight. She's going to be up. Okay. Let me compose my motherfucking self. Pre-workout is kicking my ass. Courtney. Thunder Thighs. That's the one. That's the new tag that I hung on her. Thunder Thighs. The Crusher. She got a good goddamn reason to be called the Crusher. And if you haven't seen it, you know, it was the calling card.
Yeah, it was.
For her to get my attention. I seen it. Somebody told me, hey, CT, you got it. Look at this young lady. She's calling out on this video. And I looked at her Instagram page and I fucking couldn't believe it.
Yeah, no, that's right.
I could not believe that shit. And you won't either. Later on, you'll see why I call it Thunder Thighs and her nickname is the Crusher, but I call it Thunder Fucking Thighs and you'll see why in a little while. But I'm not gonna give it away if you don't know. But tell them what your Instagram is.
It's just Courtney _ Olsen.
And
K,
Facebook.
With
and
the
all,
K.
Facebook and all that stuff.
Courtney Olsen.
Okay.
With the K.
Facebook. You will see some unbelievable shit. Most of the time when I talk about a sidewalk cracker, I'm talking about guys. And cracker is also spelled with a K.
Oh, there you go. It's meant for me. It was meant for me, like,
Yeah,
9 years meth, hardcore meth addict. I know it's hard to believe, we do recover, but if that, you know, if that lights me up, I'm gonna let the world know.
Oh,
I will I'll shout it from the rooftops.
9 years.
9 years, yeah. Yeah.
9 years, meth addict, yeah. Addicted.
Addicted hard.
And now you have changed your addiction.
Yes,
smashing
shit.
He's addicted to smashing shit. And also, Courtney and I have a lot of common, like to have fun.
Yeah.
But she also has a very important message. And she told me out front, she says, I'm an evangelist. And I ain't heard that term in a long time. But I grew up in church, so I know exactly what she's talking about. Evangelists go around spreading the word to as many people as they possibly can.
That's right.
And she wants to spread the word to as many people as she possibly can, so that's why I'm sure she calls herself an evangelist.
Yeah.
So tell us more about that. What message are you trying to get out for me?
Well, I identify with men as well. Sometimes I wake up and I think, man, am I a man trapped in a woman's body? You know, like, I used to pee standing up when I was a kid, because I idolized my brother so much, right?
Oh my goodness.
I get off externally, like all sorts of interesting shit, you know what I mean? And I've got a lot of male traits, but I've been told by a few mediums, different mediums, that this is my first lifetime as a female. And that, you know,
all the rest of the time you were a guy.
Yeah, all the other times I've been a guy. Hey, I don't know. I keep an open mind. I don't know shit. You know, I don't know. Don't know the answers. But if this is my first lifetime as a female, then my role is to help women step into our power. Because myself, my brands, we believe that the earth is lacking the female energy and the female spirit. And that's why our planet is so fucked up. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, if we were running shit properly, you know, why are people in prison making things for corporations and making them more rich? Why aren't we out there planting stuff in the fields and helping people from starvation? You know, there's so many simple answers out there, but it's because women are held back because A, we're brought up to see each other as competition. So when Kim walked in, you know, like 6 years ago, I would have been like, nice ass, bitch. Who's this bitch, right? But I walked up to her and I'm like, damn, I felt her leg. I was like, shit, that's like a board.
Yeah.
You know,
we hugged.
Yeah. So it's about like breaking down those barriers, like not your competition. And that we gotta be, in order for us to succeed out there and gain equality, we have to see each other as sisters and work together, you know, but the media, advertising, all this bullshit that wants to keep us held back and see each other as competition, is that paradigm is starting to shatter and it's starting to break. So it just starts with awareness.
Right,
you know, and showing women that we are built to rip shit up. Like, I believe any woman can smash a watermelon and it all starts right here. And that's why I was drawn to you, because your message is up here.
Oh, that's so important.
It's so up here.
So important.
The mind controls everything.
Everything. That's right.
Everything.
Yeah.
You know, but we're not taught that shit in school,
exactly.
Are we? We're taught to regurgitate facts. I don't give a fuck who the 32nd president of the United States was, and nor will I ever.
Ooh, did you hear that?
Sorry, not sorry.
MC squared motherfuckers.
But what I do care about is learning about things like assertiveness and teaching women how to step into their power, you know, not to a point where we're, you know, this isn't about like burn our bras and we're fucking feminists and all this, but step into our power and assert ourselves and be like, yeah, we can do that too. We are strong. We're built for that. You know, we have like wider hips for childbearing,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And so we have a lower center of gravity. We're more determined. We're more agile. We're more fierce as fuck.
Oh my goodness.
Right?
I had some of the Kim over there. Yeah, amen. Follow the leader voiced a lot of the same similar things. Women, a lot of times, women, when they see other women, if they're beautiful, whatever, the first thing, you know.
Right?
Yeah. So, I mean, she had the same message when I talked to her. And she also had a similar message in that everybody doesn't have to fit into it. Her thing is thick thighs also. Thick thighs save lives. I think that's her saying. Thick thighs save lives. And everybody don't have to be a petite, little, you know, it's a whole lot of room in there for everybody. I mean, and I'm sure Courtney has one hell of a following, and if it was just room for the models, then we wouldn't.
But that's the five, that's it, that's the 5%.
Oh.
The models are the 5% that's used in advertising and media. And I was telling Kim, my whole life I've been trying to be a size zero. Because that's what Calvin Klein told me that I needed to be in order to be beautiful, right?
Really?
Well, and then I found out if I had a fucking dollar for every time a man came up to me and said, oh my God, how'd you get your legs? And I'm like, what? You know, I'd be like Richard Branson, my island, bitch. You know what I mean? It's Lake Day, bitch. You gotta go. This is mine now. I'm rich as fuck.
Yeah.
But, you know, so women are starting to get the message and understand that we are built, like a majority of us are built for that, and it's okay if your legs rub together,
yeah,
you know,
I guess so.
Like stuff used to not fit. And I'd be like, but now it's a whole new ball game.
Yep, it is a whole new ball game. And thanks to women like you and Lita and Allie there, shit, they changing the
motherfucking game.
Changing the motherfucking game. And motherfucker, I fucking love it. So.
I love the F word. I do. It feels so good. I know. I'm aiming to be a bit more graceful, you know, because it's a challenge. Because women aren't supposed to cuss. You know, really? You act like a girl.
Oh my
you
God.
You put that Maya. Skirt on. Get Maya. Your ass in the kitchen, and I said, "Fuck that."
My Aunt Hattie B. I talk about her name. Hattie B. Gooseberry was her name. That's a fucking name for you. Hattie B. Gooseberry from Pine Bluff, Arkansas. She was the first one who gave me my first lesson on how to fight. My aunt. And you know what she told me?
What?
She said, ball your fists up real tight and hit him in the fucking face. That was my first instruction. And that was my aunt. My aunt told me that. Yeah. And she was like, she was a fucking hero of mine. And she was known for beating the shit out of dudes. She would whoop a fucking man or dude in a fucking minute, man. Aunt. Quick. He was the Sonny Liston of Pine Bluff, Arkansas. She would knock your ass out. So strong women, you know, I've been around since I was born.
Yeah.
And now fucking 1959. So they've been around a long time ago. So strong women, I raised with my mother, were super strong. She was strong physically, then she got sick. But what was really so super strong about him, where I went to the mind being so powerful, is her character. Her character and where I get my strength from was watching her. You know, that's where I got my strength. It stayed motherfucking set came from my mom.
Right.
Because I seen her go through a whole lot of stuff. Courtney, she went through a whole lot of stuff. Yep. And she took that shit.
Yep.
And every time you see her, she had a smile on her face.
Yep.
And if you asked her, how you doing? She said, I'm blessed. I don't give a fuck what she was going through. She said, I'm blessed, Courtney. Yep. So that is incredibly strong, super strong. There's this strength, and then you got this strength up here. The strength of heart, the strength of character, to me, which is so much more powerful than just physical strength. I admire physical strength. That was my, you know, my profession.
Yeah,
it was fucking physical strength.
Right.
But this here, the strength of character, heart, is so much more powerful to me.
You had to find
strength.
That. Did you always have that, like, though, prior to your situation?
No. When I was young, the only thing that mattered to me was physical strength.
Right.
I mean, that was it. I thought that, you know, it was, if I wouldn't have known what to do if I wasn't strong.
Right.
If I, you know, because my whole life, that was my, that was me. You're absolutely right. That's what I was born into. You know, strength was celebrated in my family.
Yep.
I heard stories of all the strong people in my family, and it was my determination from a little kid to be the strongest motherfucker in the world.
Yeah.
The king of fucking beasts, Corbin. That was my determination from as long as I can remember. But one day, I'm gonna sit on top of the throne, and I like hearing your stories, and it's wonderful about what my grandpa did, and all this kind of shit. But one day, C.T. Fletcher is going to be recognized as the fucking king of the beast. And I can't wait. But, and like I was telling Allie, it is so important and so powerful. She determined that she would come out and tell the world that her goal is to be a world champion.
Yep.
The best on the fucking planet.
Yeah.
It's hard. It's hard to do that. Now,
and at that age, huh?
Yes.
Yeah, knowing at that age.
What's your goals? What are your goals?
I'm smashing them already.
Yeah, you're smashing.
No pun intended.
Okay, well, besides smashing watermelons and having the biggest thighs on the planet and the strongest thighs on the planet, what else would you like to see? I know it's got to tie into the evangelist and getting the word out there.
It does. It's speaking.
Right.
You know, when I first saw you and I was like, man, I see us. I visualize a lot. You know, that the tool of visualization is so powerful.
Super.
Right?
Super. Yeah.
And like, I see you and I out there, like, in, you know, stages with kids, because that's where it's got to change. And the way that the schools are right now and what these young people are brought into with social media, it's like you can touch an app and you're fucking perfect, flawless, right? And
right.
then you get on there and it's like there's no education around, like, this is not real life. This is fucking real life.
Yeah.
This is not real life. Your friends on here, you feel like you have all these friends, but you're disconnected. You know, you can censor your comments and, you know, delete shit, and it's not heartfelt. You know, they text each other. I was texting you.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes it's just easier, but, you know, it's just so much different than picking up the phone or having a face-to-face conversation, Because our words are just like 10%. It's right. Body language. As I was sitting here talking to you, and I'm like, oh, I better cross my arms. I look kind of fed up. And I was like, yeah, you know, keep talking. And teaching them these basic things so we can do something different with the world, because the way it's going, I mean, look at our two presidential candidates.
Oh,
what man. The fuck? You serious? I mean, I won't go there because we don't talk politics. We don't talk religion.
No, right,
we
right.
keep it, you know,
right.
we have that right. one common bond of wanting to change people
yep,
for
exactly.
the better. And yep. we don't want to nitpick and all this other bullshit, but it just, it frightens me a little bit.
Yep.
You know, and I want to give people tools and power. And I sometimes just think like, all right, I see myself as the female Tony Robbins.
Yeah.
You know, getting up there and getting people fired up and giving them tools and bringing, I just want to continue making this sisterhood as strong as possible.
And that is the goal.
That's the goal.
That's the goal.
That's the goal.
I have a saying I like to say, no race, no religion, no politics, because we are all the same under yep. the bar.
That's it.
So,
that's it.
In here, in the weightlifting world, we all ain't no fucking ain't none of that shit. We're all the same under the bar. We come here, that's what we fucking weightlifts. We pick shit up and put shit down. That's what we do. That's what put them up for weight. Occupation, weightlift. I pick shit up, I put shit down. That's what I do. You cut grass, flip pancakes, whatever the fuck you do. This what I do. I lift shit. That's what I do. I'm weightlifting. Yeah. Some weightlifting.
Yeah.
She do other shit too, but you'll see later.
Yeah. It's been great, and I see us doing big shit.
Thunder.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you so much for having us.
So we're gonna
We're excited to smash some, yeah, smash they're gonna, some goals.
Courtney's gonna do some impressive shit. Allie's gonna take the world famous 5 minute squat challenge.
Woo!
And keep your eyeballs peeled, mother plucker. All right. We're out of here on that one. Get me up.
there you go. I'm pretty sure hers are bigger.
So if her thighs are 29 or 30 inches, that's fucking ridiculous. But if they're bigger than that, I'm finna get my truck and go the fuck home. I'm leaving. I'm gonna fucking leave.
Ooh, sidewalk cracker.
Were you supposed to measure like half length and then or just take it from the thickest part?
It's
I don't know.
Ram.
We're gonna have the king.
Oh, you want me?
Yeah.
Look, I'm nervous in a month.
It's pre-workout. Oh my god.
I don't know if it's all pre-workout.
Oh yeah.
Here?
Yeah.
Oh hi. That's good?
I think that's good.
Jesus Christ.
Damn! Zing! Is that about right?
What do you think? Drew getting me closer.
28.
Damn.
I told
okay.
you guys.
Wow, you got me.
Look, that is a waistline. 28 inch thighs. I think fucking what's it, football player? Bo Jackson, I think his was 30s. I think his was 30s. And this is, and he was known for having
huge. Oh, you
huge.
Hear me? We wanna measure. We gotta see.
He was known for having huge fucking thighs. So you know, once you get through squatting, they'll pump up to some 30 fucking inch.
Yeah, real quick.
Watch this though.
30 inch thighs.
KO knows. Right. Bo don't know. KO arm. Knows. I'm saying 30.
No way.
Yeah.
Oh, but see, you're getting from the thick part.
That's where you go.
Yeah, okay.
What about the thickest part?
Oh, shit.
No. No, it's the same. It's the
no,
same.
No, it's
the same.
It's 28 and a half.
No, but you got hers tighter. No, I don't know. I think we're the same. That's insane.
I told you.
What the fuck?
I told you. It's wow. like that, man. I told you.
Oh, my
I
God.
Did you see that shit?
Hey,
I guarantee you, when she gets through squatting, it's gonna be fucking 30s. 5 minute squat challenge, and she gets double extra credit, no knee wraps. So the only thing powering Allie will be her. And them big ass 28 and a half inch, which will be 30 inch thighs.
But fucking after the pump.
When
for
she
sure.
gets through doing this shit. So Allie Ludwig, the incredible Allie Ludwig, will take the 5-minute squat challenge.
Let's go.
Oh, yeah, right. Yeah. Right. Anytime you're ready.
All right. Yeah.
to remeasure.
That was fucking incredible.
Well, I lost.
With a smile on, she was like this. Tongue out. Damn. Ladies and gentlemen.
With 135 pounds.
That's fucking right.
That is incredible.
That's the thing. It went faster than I was hoping.
Look, she's squatting 405, but I guarantee you that was harder than squatting 405 once. Yes.
My back is my fucking shit.
Yeah.
I have not done any
of this. Look at her, dude.
Yeah. I have not done any more than 5 reps.
Yep.
In 2 years.
Yep.
Two and a half years.
You asked an Olympic lifter or a power lifter to do that many fucking reps.
One rep.
It's incredible. That is incredible. And no fucking knee wraps. No squat suit, none of that extra bullshit.
And I fucking trained her earlier today, bitches.
Just, girl.
Her.
For 3 hours.
Just her. All
size
her.
Size Alley.
Right.
Thank you for helping us change the world.
A whole lot of men can't do that shit. That
I'm
was
just
fucking
the conduit.
Incredible.
We're just the conduits, aren't we?
Wow, this is insane.
Hey, strong. We're celebrating strong women here at
That's
Iron
right.
Addicts.
That's
and
right.
we got three. Come here, Kim.
There you go.
Three of the strongest.
Right here.
Three of the strongest right here.
You know that's right.
You know that's right.
Honored, huh?
We're gonna have the world on the sidewalk
crap. I'm proud to be Oh yeah, she did have some sidewalk.
Uh-huh. I think you're onto something.
That's a good fucking testament to sidewalk.
Hell yeah. I vouch for that shit 100%. 100%.
That was fucking incredible.
Hey, thank you
putting
me up for the challenge.
Thank you.
It's an honor.
Challenge accepted, challenge conquered.
Baby.
Aww, Allie Ludwig. The great, the great Allie Ludwig.
That's what's up. Like a girl.
That was fun.
Are you rolling?
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Rolling.
So I believe.
The Crusher.
I believe that all women can do this because it's all in here and it's all in the hips. It's all in the hips. Huh? Have you seen Happy Gilmore?
Seeing how I ain't got none. I take your word for it.
So,
the Crusher, Thunder Thighs. Now you'll see why I call her Thunder Thighs.
And the thing too I tell women is like, if you don't get it the first time, find a different way, right? Everybody wants to give up. Well, fuck that shit.
Oh, ain't no fucking giving up around here.
Right?
It's the valley of the beast.
Oh, man. That's what's up. I don't care if you gotta punch it. I don't care if you have to punch it. You gotta throw that shit on the ground. You find a different way, right? So,
man, Rob didn't do this next.
Come on, Rob.
See, the only thing is the balls get in the way.
Oh,
so we don't have that problem. We don't have that problem. So you get it up close.
You have to rush Rob to the emergency. Fucking balls up
there. You get up on your hands and you visualize. Ah! Woo-hoo! That's what's up. I forgot to stretch.
Wow.
I please don't pull I have compassion for that. That motherfucker waterman was straining. It put up a fight, but it was no match for Thunder Thighs. Oh my God.
And we never waste food. We don't do that because that's just lame. So we're going to just put it back together again and we're going to put it in the fridge until somebody wants a piece.
I heard that fucking watermelon said, fuck. That watermelon said, fuck. I heard it. Oh my God.
So there's all sorts of different ways to demonstrate strength. And women are full of them. We just have to break the paradigm. And that's what's up.
Kim.
Bring your ass in here, hang out with Kim, hang out with Allie, right? Hang out with people that want to help change the game.
Did you see that shit?
There you go. Love Thunder Thighs.
That's the first time I ever seen a watermelon talk. Watermelon said, fuck. It was crying. I said, why am I having a little tear?
Had a few tears.
I'm not scared. That was fucking unbelievable. I've seen this shit. Yep. That was next level.
Yeah.
So strong women.
Strong women everywhere. Get your watermelons out. Okay? Thanks, man.